What's up, guys? It's the veins popping, panty dropping, blast doubling, stay flexing. Zeke Terenza here, and it's just another day in the animal kingdom. All right, so today, I don't know if you guys can see it in the background, but outside of Pokeball, the place is fire. It's just sponsoring me. Be Liddy as a titty. All right, so the workout that I've been promising, a glutes and hamstring focus workout, is here. So it's going to be hamstrings, glutes, and hips, all focused. Now, a lot of people don't train their hips enough, which is really not smart because you want healthy hips. And it's going to help with all your power moves, such as deadlift, squat, and yes, even bench, keeping those glutes tight under heavier load, okay? So we're going to start this off with a deadlift, 3x8, go kind of heavy. So 6, 7, 8 should be very hard. If you think you can get more after, you need to up the weight, okay? So the reason why I'm using an 6 to 8 rep range, or trying to only go up to 8, is because I'm trying to build my strength back up and get some power out of it, all right? So that's the first thing. Remember, butt down, break the bar, chest up, push through the floor, hips in, you already know. And if you guys need to know how to deadlift, go back to my other video and go ahead and watch that on how to deadlift, okay? Next thing we're gonna move on to is a single leg hamstring curl. With this, think about pulling with your heel. A lot of people tend to engage their calf too much and don't try to lay all the way down, depending on the machine you have, because you're gonna start to use your momentum a little too much, and that's what people tend to do. We don't wanna do that. So think about pulling with the heel, and the reason why we're going a lot of this stuff is gonna be a lot of single leg, I'm gonna get some air in here, is because I notice I'm tending to use my left side or my right side a little more than the other, so I want to bring up the strength of one side. Now, all this stuff you can do bilateral, which means two at the same time, or you can do it like I'm doing, single leg, okay? And keep the same rep range, you're going to get the same results. You're just going to be able to go heavier, that's all. All right, so after that, the single leg hamstring curl went to a single leg hip thrust. Now, a lot of people may not have seen this before, so it's like a regular hip thrust. Instead, you're probably going to use a dumbbell because it'll be easier to hold, and the bar won't waver. If you have a bar, it's gonna wanna waver, all right? So you're gonna use a dumbbell, take it sideways, as you'll see in the video, and place it kinda right along inside your psoas, or your hip, front of your hips. And then where you want your feet, you want the ankle right above the knee, and that foot is the one working. The reason why my other leg is straight, because I'm trying to gain stability in the other leg. So we're working both at the same time, but one's doing the power, while one is stabilizing everything else, all right? Give that a try. I know you guys will like that, and that will really help equal out your glutes, which will help and help in the strength aspect. A lot of people, when they squat, you'll see sometimes when they put their hips in, they end up turning at the end. That could be because of a weak glutes or one stronger than the other. So that's what we're trying to bring up also, all right? I don't have that problem. It's just when I hurt my back, I stopped using my glutes in my squat, which is really stupid, but so now I gotta teach myself to do that again, all right? Next thing is going to be a hip adduction and abduction superset. So usually almost, I think their cards are not, out of 9 out of 10 times, every gym I go to, these two machines are right next to each other, so you can do the superset. I made a TikTok about this. I don't know if you guys follow my TikTok, but give it a try. Zeke Terenza _ and then period in the middle _, just like my Instagram. But so I'll take my cup or my jacket or something of mine and put it on one machine while I'm using the other. So that way I can superset them and no one's gonna bother me, all right? So this machine is not meant to go heavy, so use it as a high rep range. So you see the first two sets I went for 15 reps, and the last set I went for 20 on each. You're going one right after the other. Once you get it done with both, then you can rest in between from there. But you wanna use them back to back. Now this next one, you've probably seen the first one, but not the second one that I'm supersetting with. It's gonna be a glute kickback, which is really gonna focus on that glute medius, which a lot of people tend to never work primarily, so it tends to be weak for a lot of people, right? These are called glute kickbacks. Think about taking your heel as high or kicking as far back as you can. That's gonna engage that glute medius, which is on the top portion of your butt, all right? Want a full round booty. You want that big peach, all right? Next thing you're gonna see is a leg kick. So that's what I'm supersetting with the glute kickbacks. It's literally just get your stability. You can hold on to something if you want. You don't have to like go free arm with it. And all you're trying to do is literally just take your leg up. You're gonna see you'll feel the front side of your hip working, which is another thing a lot of people neglect, and it's going to help keep you from tearing a labrum, which if you do tear a labrum, that will keep you out for about 6 to 8 months. So we don't want that. So we want healthy labrums, healthy hips. It's going to help with our squat, make us stronger overall, and keep us out of being injured, all right? Because once we're injured, then we got to get out of the gym, all right? Well, not necessarily. You just got to work around it, but it's not going to be fun, all right? Next thing is going to be a banded backward lunge. So you start standing regular, take a step back. Probably talking a little fast, aren't I? I'll slow it down a little bit. So banded backward lunge, you're going to put that band tied to something around that's firm, bring it kind of up your thigh close to your groin, and then that leg that has the band on it is the one that's going to stay in the front, and the other one is going to step back into a lunge. So this is going to help on your glute stability a lot and your knee stability. A lot of people, when they have that knee cave, is because this. They don't have that knee stability, all right? So that whole time, you're trying to keep your knee aligned with your foot. Don't go in and get knee valgus, and don't go out trying to push that knee out. You want to keep it right in line with that knee the whole entire time. You don't have to get a super hard band, just something that's going to pull on it, all right? And then if you want to add weight like I did, you're going to put it in the opposite hand of the banded leg, okay? So if I have a band on my left leg, I'm going to carry it with my right. Another thing is, you can make it harder by stepping back and then stepping back in each time, or just stay in the split squat stance the whole time, all right? Give that a try. That'll be hard. Next one is single leg. Oh yeah, single leg extension. So we're going to incorporate a little quads in here, even though it's hamstring dominant. So I'm going to finish off. So lunges obviously worked it. I'm going to finish off with leg extensions, just to isolate, go 12 reps on each leg. Nothing too fancy, you know, just getting those quads, quadzilla over here. But really right now, my main focus probably is trying to build up my hamstrings, because when I hurt my back, I didn't really train hamstrings as hard. So I think they're weak, so I got to build those back up. All right, same thing with my glutes. All right, so that's the workout for today. The only thing I did after that was calves, but you already know the drill. I didn't do anything fancy. When I do something fancy, then I'll film them, okay? All right, so I'll see you guys next time. Make sure to follow all those social medias in the description below. I see you guys representing other YouTubers. Represent me. I'm the one. I'm the best, all right? And I'll see you guys next time. Peace!